Yeah, so the mutation, so I think the only way that we do that, so we image the bone marrow by two photon microscopy, and the only way to non-invasively image the bone marrow is to actually image the calvaria, so the flat bones of the head of the mice. And we can do that with two photon without cutting in any bones. And we can reiterate the imaging in the same mice. So for the one patient samples that we inject, we can, in the mice, look at the development stage of the disease from initiating events to late-stage events. So that's a longitudinal study of one patient. But of course, we would like to see, over the time, having hopefully a patient at different stage of their disease to see whether or not we could, we could make sense of, whether there's differences. But as you mentioned, it's going to be difficult. Genetically, we don't know what cells we image. So what we have developed, and because also of the restriction of, we are interested in a stroma environment at the present time, and we are working with human leukemia, but all the environment is still a mouse. So we are aware that there's limitation to look at, human stroma. So we have developed this scaffolding system, which is essentially a sponge of collagen that we can seed with different human stroma cells. And at the present time, we are at the level of adding two stroma cells, two major stroma cells, a mesenchymal stroma cell, stroma cells, where we add human endothelial progenitor cells. So we have at least two components of the stroma. And we precede that with our hematopoietic cells, either leukemia or normal. And we seed these subcutaneously into the mice. And around 12 to 16 weeks later, we actually find ossicles, small bone-ish structure in the back of these mice. And this could also be imaged because this just at the surface of these. And these constitute a small human niche environment, and we are trying to look into that. And the interest with that is quite versatile. We can change the nature of the endothelial cells that we put. We can modulate certain genes pathway into these different cells that we seed. Same for the mesenchymal stroma cells. And the advantage of that is also because we can implant probably in between four to six of these scaffold into the mice. We could also look into, clonal variation between different scaffold is a major clone developing in different region. So that's where we are going to do, dissecting each of these compartment, modulating certain factors in the environment of the scaffold, and in order to try to see whether, there's preferential growth based on a specific factor of a subclone present in these patient samples. And we do mixed genomic analysis. If that is true, we could potentially envisage also to mark different clones with barcoding system and try to see where they go physically. And they exchange cells because there's vascularization is working. So it will be interesting to see, how they move around from scaffold to scaffold and potentially go back even in a mouse niche and see the differences between what they do in a human situation versus what they do in a human mouse bone marrow situation.